Welcome back to Developers' Introduction to Data Science. A common question that many customers, developers, but also data scientists ask me is, which machine learning algorithm should I use? I always answer, it depends. It depends on many different factors, but most importantly, the algorithm that you select depends on one aspect of your data science scenario. What do you want to do with your data? So this is the most important questions that you should ask yourself. And specifically, another important question is, what is the business questions that you want to answer by learning from your past data? Machine learning has many different algorithms, and each different algorithm can help you achieve a different goal and answer a different questions. So let's see some of these. The first one is predict between different categories. Here we have two different types of methods. We have the two-class classification, which is great at answering questions that are two-choice questions, like yes or no, true or false. Then we have the multi-class classification, which is great at answering complex questions with multiple possible options. You can also use machine learning and your data to discover patterns in your data. Here we have three different types of methods, such as recommenders that are great at predicting what someone will be interested in the future. Clustering is great at separating similar data points into groups. Finally, anomaly detection, which is great at identifying and predicting rare or unusual data points. Another thing that you can do with your data is actually understanding what an image is representing and also understanding natural language. Here we have methods such as image classification that is able to identify image with neural networks, and also text analytics that is able to derive high quality information from text. Finally, if you need to predict the results based on the relationship between values, you can use a different type of regressions method. With regression, in general, it's great at making forecasts by estimating the relationship between your values. For this specific use case that Sarah is trying to solve, I think that we need to predict how many bikes will be rented in the next hour. So I really think that the prediction, and most importantly regression, is the right method that we should use, because we really want to predict an outcome based on the relationship between values.